help you any way I can.
Except in the way that I really need.
Yeah, but disappearing, it's not fair to anybody.
What's fair about AIDS to begin with? What's fair about a 19-year-old boy having to die before he gets a chance to live? Or about a disease ravaging Africa, okay? I'm not thinking about what is fair. I'm thinking about what is best for my family.
Well, you're what's best. Patrick and Emma need you with them.
Do you think that I want to leave right now? I am in love with my husband. I can't even believe that I found this most beautiful, brilliant man to agree to marry me. I mean, we're supposed to grow old together.
Well, you still could.
And my daughter, I mean, Emma, every time I look at her, my heart is just bursting with love. I mean, I don't even want to go to work. I don't want to leave her to go to work. You think I want to leave her forever?
Then don't leave, Robin.
Jason, I know what's coming. I have lived through it. I have lived through that with Stone.
But you're giving in to fear right now. You're convincing yourself that there's no hope at all.
I can read my test results. The numbers are very
clear. The numbers can improve. You're not even giving your new meds a chance to work yet.
I know how horrible and annihilating it is to sit there and have to watch someone die, okay? I am not going to do that to my family.
Whatever you're going through, Patrick deserves to know.
Is that what you would want? I mean, if Sam, if something was happening to her, if a disease was ravaging her body, if she was getting weaker all the time, you're honestly going to sit there and tell me that you would want to watch that?
I wouldn't even have to think about it. I'd want to be with her through whatever happens.
How long were you just going to sit here?
It hasn't been that long.
Every second counts, and Abby needs me.
I know. And you have done everything humanly possible to make sure you get there, so just try and relax, okay?
How?
How?
Abby could be seriously hurt.
Welcome aboard flight 3.7 nonstop service to Chicago. We'll be pushing back from the gate.
Thank God.
At this time, we ask
hey, just so you know, I make sure there's a car service ready for us when we land.
I sent Abby to Chicago so she would be safe.
It was a good instinct.
If something happens to her, it'll be my fault.
Don't do that. You have done everything you can to protect her.
She has to be okay, Sam. I can't lose Abby. I can't.
You are the worst patient I've ever seen. It turns out I am, too.
I mean, what about what Patrick wants?
What if it was you? Really, what if...
Right.
What if you were the one that was sick, and you were fading away little by little? You would want Sam to see that? No. I know you. You would get on your motorcycle, you would drive out of town, you'd find the nearest body of water, and you would walk right into it. I know it.
You don't think that Patrick's gonna blame himself if you disappear? Feel like he failed you because you couldn't tell him what was going on.
I'm just exhausted, Jason. I can't do this anymore.
Well, maybe you're
constant
tired
covering.
Because you're trying to go through this by yourself.
I'm not by myself anymore. I have you. You're going to help me through this.
But leaving is not a solution.
It's the right thing to do.
What about Emma?
I was older than Emma when my parents first disappeared when I thought that they were dead. And of course, I missed them so much, but I remembered them in a good way. You know, my dad always making everything into a joke. My mom being the bravest, most beautiful woman I'd ever seen.
And you don't think Emma sees you that way? You want to take that away from her?
How could you give up Jake? I mean, how could you let someone else be his dad?
I mean, he didn't know that I was his father, but I was trying to do what was right for him.
Exactly. Jason, that's what I'm trying to do.
Yeah, I know, but if you suddenly disappear, Patrick's gonna have to explain to Emma what happened and make it okay for her. You gotta stop shutting him out. And if you're not gonna tell him as your husband, you need to tell him as Emma's father.
But I want her to remember the good things, you know? I want her to remember us. Waking up in the morning and making crepes and being in our PJs till noon. I don't want her to see me sick. It's kind of already happened.
When?
At Thanksgiving. I was so tired I could barely keep my eyes open and I had to leave the table. She was so disappointed. That's why Christmas has to be really special. It has to be a really good last memory for Patrick and for my little girl.
Do you remember a night on the bridge?
There were a lot of nights on the bridge.
Yeah, I mean, there was a night that you were really upset because a girl with AIDS had died.
Janetta.
And you told me that it was only a matter of time before it was you, and you didn't want to go through that. So we stood on the side. And we were holding hands. Do you remember what happened?
We didn't jump.
What if we had? What if we had? Think of all the things we would have missed. You never would have become adopted. You never would have met Patrick. You never would have had your baby girl. It's too soon to jump.
It was unthinkable, right? After everything Abby went through with that bastard Randon knocking her around. To be in a situation where she can get hurt the same way again.
No. Don't think like that, Michael. You've got to try and stay calm.
She was supposed to be safe in Chicago. What if we're too late?
Well, I mean, she's a really strong woman. She knows how to take care of herself.
So if something happens to her, I have no idea what I'm going to do. Probably go after the nearest doctor that I see. Like Jason did to Floyd. That was strange, right? Usually when a cop or somebody like that gets in Jason's face, he just shuts down usually, but I thought he was gonna kill Floyd.
Yeah, well, thank God he didn't, because we have enough to deal with right now.
Do you think maybe these rage attacks have something to do with the surgery? Like their side effects or something?
You something about the bridge.
Yeah?
Are you the one that donated the money?
Yes, I am.
Why?
Because I missed it.
Me too. Have you been out there?
Yeah, a couple times.
So what do you think?
I think it sucks.
That's exactly what I thought. You know, next time you donate money, you have to give them a detailed description of exactly what you want built.
Yeah, maybe it's better this way. You know, you can't bring back something that's gone.
That's true. But you can remember it. You can be very grateful for what you had.
You know, what I learned from you, it changed my life.
Me too. After Stone died, I thought my life was over. I was on the bridge, and then there you were. The guy with no past, and the girl with no future.
Come on, you have a future.
It really was because of you that I was able to move on. I mean, even though we didn't work out, you'll always be my friend. And because of you, I was able to believe that I could find love again, and I did. I found Patrick, you know, love of my life.
Well, if you mean that, and if you really love him, you need to give him the chance to know what's going on.
If you don't agree with me, I mean, you clearly don't, I need you to respect my decision and not say anything to Patrick.
I won't say anything to Patrick.
Thank you.
You need to be the one who says something to Patrick.
Jason. Robin, what are you doing here? Where's Alexis?
I imagine trying to get Jason released.
Don't tell me you're here whining about the mess you're in over the Lisa Niles murder.
Carly, stop.
No, you have more important things to deal with right now, Jason.
Having to do with you, I'm sure.
No, Robin, you're wrong. I'm trying to protect my daughter.
While you're visiting Jason and your daughter's at home with, what, the nanny and the bodyguard?
Are you that caught up in your own drama you don't know what's going on? Franco's back.
Yeah, I do know that, actually. And Garrett Floyd was giving Jason grief, and that's why he got so upset, and that's why he's here.
Well, you know what? Franco is sending my daughter threatening messages. Okay, this man wants to be a daddy. Is that serious enough for you?
He wants my daughter.
No!
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Not fine.
I don't want to hear the two of you fight. That's all.
Okay, I'm sorry.
That's it.
I get it. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Is that what happened with the mayor, ex-mayor? You blew up at him like that?
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, I haven't seen you lose your temper like that.
Yeah, I just got a lot going on right now.
I'm sorry. I know my visit probably didn't help much.
I'm glad you came to see me.
You want to help? Ask Matt to let Jason.
Alexis is working on getting me out, Carly.
Are you having any other symptoms? Blurred vision, headaches, anything like that?
Why? Oh. Is there something wrong with the surgery?
Nothing's wrong.
Have you been back for checkups since you got back from Hawaii?
No, I've been busy.
Come on. I know you hate hospitals. I know you avoid them like the plague.
Yeah, that too.
Okay, Jason. You gotta go in for the checkup. That's how we know you're okay.
I hope you're listening, because for the first time, Carly and I are in agreement. You have to call Patrick. Please call him. Make an appointment. Don't blow it off.
You're the one who needs to talk to Patrick.
Call him.
All right, that's a lot. That was about a lot more than a checkup. What's going on?
Carly needed to talk.
And she picks now to talk to you? I mean, she calls me selfish. What the hell?
Stop. Don't start.
It just never ceases to amaze me how she's so anxious.
I just asked you not to start.
Okay. I'm sorry. Calm down. Jeez. I'm worried, all right? I'm worried. This whole checkup thing has me freaked out.
She's a doctor. That's her job.
Come on. I've seen you lose it 3 or 4 times lately. And it's not over me and Robin fighting, because we do it all the time. What the hell is going on? You didn't answer Robin's question. Are you having headaches?
It's nothing serious.
How do you know?
Because when I had my seizure and my blackouts, it felt like someone was sticking an ice pick through my forehead, and it doesn't feel that way right now, so I'm fine.
No, you're not. I have watched you be interrogated by the police. I have seen a lawyer hammer you on the witness stand, and you do nothing. You don't even react at all. Why would you lose it with a guy like Garrett Floor?
I don't know. I shouldn't have.
That's not an answer.
That's my answer.
I'm scared, okay? I'm scared. Franco is sending Jocelyn messages and little baby dolls. It is clear that he is fixated on her.
I don't think so. I'm trying to get Franco right now. Alexis is trying to get me released.
You're not yourself, Jason. I mean, did something happen with the surgery?
Well, all I did was miss a checkup.
And then what?
Then what? I don't know what. Carly, I'm angry. What do you want me to say? Sam and I got married. I thought I could give her just a little bit of happiness.
Okay, are you and Sam having problems?
But my problem is Franco.
That's not it, Jason, or Sam would be here.
I don't want Sam here. I want her at home. With Michael.
Michael? Why is Michael in this?
Because Franco spray-painted something new in the alley at Jake's. And Michael showed up with Sam, and then Mayor Floyd came in, and that's when this whole thing...
I don't want Michael involved with anything that has to do with Franco. He has suffered enough from that freak.
Michael is safe at the pet house, okay? You have nothing to worry about.
We'll be making our final descent into Chicago in just a few minutes. Please make sure your seatbelts are securely...
Everything's going to be fine.
All three tables and seatbacks are in the upright.
But Abby is going to be fine. And you have to believe that.
Got dizzy in the shower. He was the one who caught you.
How long did you play games?
I wouldn't find that you shot instantly.
See what? They're the same.